So good day everyone and welcome to the part 2 video on integration concepts and formulas. So in this lecture, you will learn about simple trigonometric functions, exponential functions, inverse trigonometric functions, hyperbolic functions, and the application of indefinite integration. So these are the desired learning outcomes. So find the general antiderivative of a given function. Explain the terms and notation used for an indefinite integral. State the power rule for integrals. Use antidifferentiation to solve simple initial value problems. So first we have here simple trigonometric functions. So these are the formulas. So the first 6, these first 6 formulas came originally from the differential calculus formulas. So ito, kabaligtaran lang siya ng differential calculus. If we try to differentiate, say for example ito, itong equation na to, if you differentiate negative cosine of u plus c with respect to u, so yung c magiging 0 and you will get sine of u du. So ganun lang yung unang 6 na formula, and the next 4, so iba yung derivation para sa ito. So, for example, ipakita ko lang for example kung paano na-derive itong 4. So, dalawa lang yung i-derive ko na lang. Pag-practice nyo na lang yung ibang dalawa. So, first is we have integral of tangent x dx. So, we can rewrite this as integral of sine of x over cosine of x dx. So, ito siya. Then, we may let u be equal to cosine x. So, substitution tayo. And differentiating both sides, we get that du is equal to cosine of, sorry, mag-differentiate na pala tayo. So, du will be equal to negative sine of x dx. So, dividing both sides by negative 1, we will get negative du is equal to sine of x dx. So, pwede na tayong mag-substitute. So, from the original equation, which was sine of x over cosine of x dx, we may substitute, this will be equal to integral of negative du, so sine x dx, ito siya sine x dx, negative du over u, which was cosine x. So labas lang natin yung negative sign, so du over u. So from the formula natin sa unang video, so integral of du over u is ln u. So this one will be equal to negative ln of u plus c. Then substitute lang natin yung u, which was ito, cosine of x. So we will have negative ln of cosine of x plus c. So ito yung formula for integrating tangent of x dx. So, ito, tan u is equal to negative ln. Ito. So, yun yung derivation niya. Next, we have integral of second x dx. So, hindi pa nga pala ito yung kung paano gamitin itong simple trigonometric functions. Nagde-derive pa lang ako. So, yan. So, we have here integral of second x dx. So we may rewrite this as secant x. So magmumultiply lang ako dito ng 1. So yung 1 na yon ay secant x plus tangent x over secant x plus tangent x. So ito magka-cancel cancel lang. So 1 ito. So minultiply ko lang siya ng 1, so wala akong binaviolate na na rule dito. So okay pa rin, equal pa rin itong equation na to. So multiplied by 1 lang. So next, distribute ko tong secant x. So this will be equal to secant squared x plus secant x tangent x over secant x plus tangent x dx. So ito. So we let u, so sorry, v equals, so we let u be equal to secant x plus tangent of x. So if we differentiate both sides, the u will be equal to, so sa hindi, kung di nyo maalala, so nandito lang din siya sa formula. So if we differentiate secant u, we get secant u tangent u. So secant u or secant x tangent x plus, para sa tangent, if we differentiate tangent, so ito nag-i-integrate ka. So if we differentiate it, so this will be secant squared u du, or ito secant squared x. So yung dx nilang dalawa, labas na lang natin siya. So ito, so ito equal siya sa nandito sa taas, tapos itong secant x tangent x is yung u. So if we rewrite the formula, so rewrite lang natin siya, secant squared x plus secant of x tangent of x over secant of x plus tangent of x dx. So ito, secant x plus tangent x plus secant squared x dx is itong nasa taas natin. So secant squared x plus secant x plus tangent x. Secant squared x plus secant x tangent x. So we may rewrite this as du, and then yung u natin is secant x plus tangent x, so over u. So this one will be ln of u plus c, na integrate na natin. So this one will be equal to ln of, yung u natin was secant of x plus tangent of x, so plus c. So yung formula originally was integral of secant of x dx. So check natin. So secant u is equal, integral of secant u du is equal to ln of secant u plus tangent u plus c. So tama naman. So let's try to use or apply the functions. So find the indefinite integral of the following. So para sa mga examples, kung gusto niyo i-try isolve, i-pause niyo na lang, and then try niyo isolve, or Kung hindi nyo naman kaya pa, ituloy nyo na lang muna yung video. So, find the indefinite integral of the following. Integral of negative 5 sine t dt. So, integral of 3 cosine 5 theta d theta. Integral of 4 secant x tangent x minus 2 secant squared x dx. And integral of 2 plus tangent theta d theta. So, mas maganda kung kabisado nyo na yung mga formulas para mas madali na lang kayo mag-integrate. So, ito. Let's try to solve. So, this one, we have integral of negative 5 sine t dt. So, rewrite lang natin. Negative 5 sine of t dt. So, pwede nating labas yung constant, which is negative 5. So, negative 5 integral of sine t dt. Now, pwede na natin siyang i-integrate yung nasa loob ng integral sign. So, negative 5. So, integral ng sine t dt. So, from the formula, so, we will have negative cosine of t plus c. So, na-integrate na siya. Negative multiplied by negative will be positive. So, this one will be equal to positive 5 cosine of t plus c. So, ito yung final answer. So, next we have here integral of 3 cosine of 5 theta d theta. So, if we try to rewrite 3 cosine of 5 theta d theta, we will get, so, ito, yan, dapat mag-let muna tayo. So, itong gagawin ko, pag ma-master nyo na na ma-imagine nyo na lang yung pag-let, okay lang sa mga solutions nyo na hindi nyo na i-let u ito. So, ang gagawin ko is let u be equal to 5 theta. So, if you differentiate both sides, du will be equal to 5 d theta. So, dividing both sides by 5. So, du over 5 will be equal to d theta. So, pakailangan natin ito mamaya. So, this will be, if we substitute du over 5 and u to the equation, we will get, so, 3 cosine of u and d theta is du over 5. So, labas lang natin yung constants natin. So, this one will be equal to 3 over 5 integral of cosine u du. So, integrating, we will get 3 over 5. So, integral of cosine is, so SDC, so sine u plus c. Substitute lang natin yung u, which was 5 theta. So this one will be 3 over 5 sine of 5 theta plus c. So next, we have here integral of 4 secant x tangent x minus 2 secant squared x dx. So, rewrite ko lang siya. 4 secant x tangent x minus 2 secant squared x dx. So, ito. pwede natin silang i-integrate separately. So, this one for secant x tangent x dx minus 2 integral of 2 secant squared x dx. So, labas natin yung mga constants. So, this one will be equal to 4 integral of secant x tangent x dx minus 2 integral of secant squared x dx. So, integrating. So, if we integrate secant x tangent x, so this one will be equal to 4 secant of x, and this one will be secant squared x dx will be negative 2. If you integrate secant squared x, so this one is tangent of x. So, plus c. So, sa huli na lang natin lagay yung plus c. So, answer. Final answer. So, next, we have here integral of 2 plus tangent theta d theta. So, 2 tangent 2 plus tangent theta d theta. So, if we integrate them separately, so this one will be equal to 2 d theta plus integral of tangent theta d theta. So, 2 d theta will be, if we integrate this, will be 2 theta plus integral of tangent theta d theta. So, yung formula, yung dinerive natin kanina, this one will be equal to, so, negative. Negative ln of, ln of cosine theta. So, plus p. So, we may rewrite this as 2 theta minus ln of cosine theta plus c. So, final answer. So, next we have exponential functions. So, these are the formulas. Integral of e raised to u du is equal to e raised to u plus c. And integral of a raised to u du. So, it is equal to a raised to u over ln of a plus the constant c. So, u is a function of x or f of x. And du is the derivative of or f prime of x. So, ito. Itong u na to is a function of x. And itong du ay yung derivative ng u. Nanggaling siya dito. Dapat. So, and a is a constant. So, itong a dito ay constant. So, ito yung formulas natin for exponential functions. So, we have here four examples. So, let's try to integrate them. So, una, integral of e raised to 4x dx. So, sulat lang natin siya. 4x dx. We try to let u be equal to 4x. Differentiating, du will be equal to, so, du is 4 dx. And then, we divide both sides by 4. So, du over 4 is equal to dx. Substitute natin siya sa itong mga to sa equation. So, hindi ko na isusulat ito. So, ang magiging equation natin is, so, e raised to 4x is u, so e raised to u, and dx will be equal to, ito, dx is equal to du over 4. So, du over 4. So, labas natin yung constant natin. So, 1/4 integral of e raised to u du. So, from the formula, so this one will be 1/4 multiplied by e raised to u plus c. So, yung e raised to u, hindi siya nag, walang nangyayari sa kanya. Kahit i-integrate mo or i-differentiate mo, e raised to u pa rin siya. So, ang effect lang niya is doon sa kung ano yung nasa exponent ng e. So, this one is not yet our final answer. So, originally, yung equation as I in terms of x, so dapat final answer I in terms of x. So, u ito, ang u natin was 4x. So, substitute lang natin, 1/4 e raised to 4x plus c. So, final answer. So, next. So, integral of 2 raised to 2x dx. So, ang constant natin dito ay itong 2. So, let lang natin yung exponent u be equal to 2x. So, if we differentiate, du will be equal to 2dx. Next, pwede na natin siyang, wait, baka malito kayo. So, dividing both sides by 2 muna dito para mas madali natin i-substitute. So, this one will be du over 2 is equal to dx. So, our equation will be, so, 2x integral of 2. Yung 2x natin sa taas will be u. And then, dx right here, substitute natin is du over 2. Du over 2. So, labas lang natin yung constant dito na hindi part ng integration or hindi mai-integrate. So, this one will be equal to 1/2. Hindi siya magka-cancel kasi ito may exponent siya na u. So, 1/2 integral of 2. Hindi natin siya ilalabas kasi yung exponent niya ay kailangang ma-integrate. So, u, du, and then from the formula, so, 1/2, formula natin sa ito, remind ko lang, u, du is equal to a raised to u over ln of a plus c. So, ito, constant, ito yung a natin, itong number 2. So, ang nangyayari, 2 raised to u over ln of ito 2 plus c. So, naka-multiply siya. So, simplify lang natin. 1/2 or ito, 2 raised to u over 2 ln of 2 plus c. And then, itong u natin will be, should be a function of x. So, 2x yung u natin. Ito. So, 2 raised to 2x over 2 ln of 2 plus c. So, pwede na natin itong final answer kasi nag-i-integrate lang tayo. Final answer. So, next, we have here 2x e raised to x squared plus 1 dx. So, pwede natin siyang isulat muna. E raised to x squared plus 1 dx. So, we let u be equal to yung exponent. So, x squared plus 1 differentiating both sides, du will be equal to 2x. So, ito, itong 1 will be 0. So, 2x dx. So, itong equation natin, pwede natin siyang i-rewrite as, iayos ko na lang, e raised to x squared plus 1 multiplied by 2x dx. So, para mas madali tayong mag-substitute. So, this one will be equal to, substitute na natin, integral of, so, e raised to x squared plus 1. Itong x squared plus 1 is u. U, and then du is equal to 2x dx. So, 2x dx. So, du, and then, pwede na natin i-integrate siya using the formula. So, this one will be equal to e raised to u plus c. So, substitute lang natin yung u. U was x squared plus 1. So, e raised to x squared plus 1 plus c. Final answer. So, next we have here integral of dx over e raised to x plus 1. So, sulat lang natin. Dx over e raised to x plus 1. So, pwede natin itong i-rewrite as integral of 1 over e raised to x plus 1 multiplied by dx. Equal siya. So, next, mag-a-add lang ako ng 0 sa taas. So, e raised to x plus 1 dx. So, 1 plus, mag-a-add ako ng 0, e raised to x minus e raised to x. So, iayos ko lang siya. This one will be equal to integral of e raised to x. So, unahin ko na itong negative. So, plus e raised to x plus 1 over e raised to x plus 1 dx. So, we may rewrite this as integral of, so, negative e raised to x over e raised to x plus 1 plus e raised to x plus 1 over e raised to x plus 1 dx. So, this one will be equal to 1. So, equal to integral of negative e raised to x over e raised to x plus 1 plus 1 dx. So, integrate ko sila separately. So, this one will be equal to integral of negative e raised to x over e raised to x plus 1 plus, sorry, e raised to x plus 1 dx plus integral of itong 1. So, integral of dx. So, ito, alam natin magiging equal to x plus c ito. So, ito muna yung gagalawin ko ngayon. So, for integral of the integral of negative e raised to x dx over e raised to x plus 1. So, I will let u be equal to e raised to x plus 1. So, du will be equal to e raised to x dx. Substitute natin sa equation na to. So, this one will be equal to e raised to x dx. So, negative siya. So, negative du over e raised to x plus 1 was u. So, labas lang natin yung negative sign. So, du over u. So, this one will be equal to negative ln of u plus c. Or, say, yung plus c na lang natin mamaya is pag na-integrate na silang dalawa. So, say, plus a na lang tayo dito. So, constant a. So, this one will be equal to negative ln of u was e raised to x plus 1. So e raised to x plus 1 plus constant p. So yung equation na integral of negative e raised to x dx over e raised to x plus 1 will be equal to negative ln of e raised to x plus 1 plus constant a. So this one, the equation will be negative ln of e raised to x plus 1 plus constant a plus integral of dx, or that would be simply x plus yung constant nga dito ay let's say b. So pag addin na lang natin itong a and b para maging isang constant, say c. So negative ln of e raised to x plus 1 plus x plus isang constant na lang siya kasi hindi naman natin alam yung values nitong dalawa. So let's say c yung constant na a plus b. So a plus b is equal to c. So next we have hyperbolic functions. So these are the equations for integrating hyperbolic functions. So memorize nyo na lang sila. And same lang din yung concept dito. Yung mga unang formulas was derived from yung differential calculus. Reverse lang yung process and then yung huli. So dito, ito is from differential calculus. And itong dalawa is pwede nyong i-derive using yung mga naunang formulas. So mas maganda, memorize nyo na lang para hindi nyo na kailangan mag-derive. So let us try to use the hyperbolic functions in solving these examples. So let's try to evaluate the first example we have here. Integral of hyperbolic sine of 3x minus 1 dx. So this one, we will let u be equal to 3x minus 1. If we differentiate both sides, du will be equal to 3 dx. Next is, we will substitute or dividing both sides muna by 3 para mas madali tayo mag-substitute para hindi nakakalito. So du over 3 will be equal to dx. So, cancel itong 3, both sides. So du over 3 will be dx. If we substitute dx and 3x minus 1 to the original equation, so we will get integral of hyperbolic sine of, so 3x minus 1 is u, and then dx is du over 3. So we will get, labas natin yung constant which is 1/3. So equal to 1/3 hyperbolic sine of u du. So using the hyperbolic formula for integrating sine hyperbolic, so we will get 1/3. So integral of sine hyperbolic is cosine hyperbolic u plus c. So hyperbolic cosine of u plus c. So next, substitute natin yung u which was 3x minus 1. So we will get 1/3 of hyperbolic cosine of 3x minus 1 plus c. So, final answer. So next, we have here integral of 2x hyperbolic cosecant squared of 1 minus x squared dx. So let us try to let u be equal to, so 1 minus x squared. If we differentiate both sides, we will get du is equal to negative 2x dx. So dividing both sides by negative 1. So du, negative du will be equal to 2x dx. Sorry. So 2x dx. Next, we will ayusin ko lang yung equation para mas madali tayo mag-substitute. This one will be equal to cosecant, hyperbolic cosecant squared of 1 minus x squared multiplied by 2x dx. So, we have here 1 minus x squared. So, ito, u. And 2x dx is equal to negative du. So, substitute natin. We will get cosecant hyperbolic squared of 1 minus x squared is u multiplied by, so negative du, hindi siya minus du. Labas natin yung negative sign. So negative integral of cosecant hyperbolic squared of u multiplied by du. So using the formula for hyperbolic cosecant squared, we will get, so negative multiplied by negative, yung formula nito is negative hyperbolic cotangent, so cotangent of u plus c. So negative multiplied by negative will be positive, so simply hyperbolic cotangent of u plus c. So yung u natin dito is 1 minus x squared, so this one will be cotangent h of 1 minus x squared so plus c. So final answer natin. Next example, we have here the integral of hyperbolic secant squared of ln of x all over x dx. So we try to let u be equal to ln of x. So differentiating both sides, we will get du is equal to dx over x. So next, pwede na natin substitute sa original equation. So we will get, this one will be equal to integral of secant hyperbolic squared of, so ln of x is u multiplied by, so dx, ito, dx over x will be du. So this one will be equal to, using the formula, so my formula tayo for hyperbolic secant squared, we will use that. So that will be hyperbolic tangent of u plus c. Substitute c, u, so ln x. So answer will be hyperbolic tangent of ln of x plus c. So final answer. So we have here our next example, hyperbolic sine of 4x over cosine hyperbolic cosine of 2x. So sulat lang natin siya. Integral of hyperbolic sine of 4x over hyperbolic cosine of 2x dx. So for this, recall lang natin yung identity, which was, so double angle identity. So for 2u is equal to 2 hyperbolic sine of u cosine h u. So meron tayong double angle identity for hyperbolic sine. So for this, para sa ating problem, we have 4x, so that would be 2 multiplied by 2x. So this one will be, yung u natin will be 2x. So 2 hyperbolic sine of 2x hyperbolic cosine of 2x. So pwede natin tong substitute dito. So we will write this as integral of 2 hyperbolic sine of 2x hyperbolic cosine of 2x all over hyperbolic cosine of 2x. So dx, cancel yung hyperbolic cosine. So this one will be equal to integral of 2 hyperbolic sine of 2x dx. So if you let u be equal to 2x, you will get the differential. So du will be 2 dx. So ito siya, 2 dx. So pwede natin i-rewrite or substitute natin directly na lang. So hyperbolic sine of, so 2x will be u, and then itong 2 multiplied by dx will be du. So using our formula for integrating hyperbolic sine, so this one will be hyperbolic cosine of u plus c. Substitute natin yung u. So yung u natin was 2x. So this one will be hyperbolic cosine of 2x plus c. So final answer. So next we have the application of indefinite integration, or what we call initial value problems. So when an equation y is equal to f of x of a curve is known, the slope m at a any point p, so point p x y on it, is given by m f prime of x. So m is equal to f prime of x, or the derivative of f of x. So conversely, when the slope of a curve at point p x y on its given on it is given by m is equal to dy over dx, or f prime of x, so a family of curves y is equal to f of x plus c may be found by integration. So to single out a particular curve of the family, it is necessary to assign or to determine a particular value of c. So this may be done by prescribing that the curve may pass through a given point. So let us try to apply this. So for our first example, so find the equation of the family of curves whose slope at any given point is equal to the negative of twice the abscissa of the point. So find the curve of the family which passes through the point 1, 1. So it is stated here that the slope m is equal to the 2 times the negative of the abscissa or x. So m is equal to negative 2x. So from sa differential calculus natin, slope is equal to dy over dx. So we have here this equation. Iayos lang natin siya. So dy over dx is equal to negative 2x. If we transpose dx, so multiply both sides by dx, we will get, so dy will be equal to negative 2x dx. if we try to integrate both sides, so this one right here, integral of dy will be equal to y, and integral of negative 2x and dx right here. So pwede natin muna siyang i-write this way. So x dx. So, negative 2 labas natin. So y will be equal to negative 2. So integrating, we will get x squared over 2 plus c. So cancel itong 2, we will get, so y will be equal to negative x squared plus c. So ito na lang tayo mag-solve. So yung stated sa problem na yung curve, so ito yung equation ng curve natin, y is equal to negative x squared plus c, general equation ng curve natin to. So family of curves ito kasi may plus c siya. And kailangan natin yung specific curve na yon na magpa-pass through point 1, 1. So at x is equal to 1, y natin is equal to 1. So given siya dito. So substitute lang natin para makuha natin kung anong constant c siya. So we will get, try to substitute. So y is equal to 1. So negative x squared, negative 1 squared plus c. So 1 is equal to negative 1 plus c transpose negative 1. So c is equal to positive 2. So ang equation ng curve na hinahanap dito will be equal to y is equal to, substitute natin yung c from the general equation right here. So y is equal to negative x squared plus 2. So ang hinahanap ay itong equation na to. Y is equal to negative x squared plus 2. Final answer. So next example we have here. Find the equation of the family of curves whose slope at any point P, xy is equal to, or yung slope m is equal to 3x squared multiplied by y. Find the equation of the curve of the family which passes through point 0, 8. So yung slope m is equal to 3x squared y, or from differential calculus, so dy over dx is equal to, or f prime of x is equal to dy over dx, or the slope of the function f of x. So dito gamitin natin yung dy over dx. So dy over dx is equal to 3x squared y. So ito yung ating equation, and dapat mag pass through point 0, 8. So rewrite lang natin, dy over dx is equal to 3x squared y. So ayusin lang natin to sa isang side, pagsasamahin natin yung variable na y and the other side variables of x. So dy over y in this side, and then the other side, so 3x squared dx. So if we try to integrate both sides, so sa kabilang side, integral of dy over y, so this one will be equal to ln of y. Yung plus na constant dito, dito na lang natin sa side na to ilalagay. So dito na lang tayo sa side na to magpla-plus c, para hindi na pa madaming plus na constants. So ln y is equal to, so itong side na to ini-integrate natin. Wait lang. So itong side na to, this one will be equal to 3 integral of x squared dx. So plus yung constant ng kanina dito. So plus c na lang tayo. And then ln y will be equal to, so integral of x squared dx will be x cube over 3. So yung plus na constant dito, ipla-plus na lang natin dito. So di pa rin naman natin alam kung ano tong constant na to. So plus c na lang tayo. So cancel ito. Ln of y will be equal to x cube plus c. So dapat para maging f of x ito, dapat yung this should be equal to y is equal to something. So pwede natin tong i-rewrite as ln of y is equal to x cube plus ln of c. So ito, di pa rin natin alam kung ano itong c na to. So okay lang na mag ln of c tayo dito. And then if we write this in exponential form, so this one will be, magka-cancel ito tsaka to, kasi dapat y is equal to a function tayo dito. So y is equal to, this one will be written as c, so magka-cancel kasi itong ln tsaka yung e nya, and then x cube, so e raised to x cube na lang siya. So dito dapat daw yung equation or family of curves should pass through point ano yan, point 0.8. So if x is equal to 0, sorry, so if x is equal to 0, y should be equal to 8. Substitute lang natin siya para makuha natin yung constant c. So we have here 8 is equal to c multiplied by e raised to, so 0 yung x, 0 cube. So if any number raised to 0 is equal to 1, so c multiplied by 1 would be 8. So ang c natin ay 8. Ang magiging formula na hinahanap will be y is equal to 8 e raised to x cube. So ito yung final answer. Bale, sinubstitute lang natin yung c doon. So bale, ang nangyari dito is ito yung general equation ng lahat ng curves, and then ito yung specific equation na hinahanap natin na magpapas through point 0.8. So ito yung final answer natin. So next, another application of indefinite integration. So an equation s is equal to f of t, where s is the distance at time t of a body from a fixed point in its straight line path, so completely defines the motion of the body. So the velocity of and acceleration at time t are given by v is equal to ds over dt or f prime of t, and a, the acceleration, is given by vv over dt or second derivative of s over dt squared is equal to f double prime of t. So conversely, if the velocity or the acceleration is known at time t together with the position or position and velocity at some given instant, usually at t is equal to 0, the equation of motion may be obtained by integrating. So we have here this example. A certain quantity q increases at a rate proportional to itself. So dq over dt is proportional to q, or we may write this as dq over dt is equal to kq. So this is directly proportional. So we have here a constant k. So pwedeng ang gawin natin na susunod is to magsasamahin yung magkakaparehong variables. So this one will be written as dq over q. And then since k is constant, so pwedeng dito lang siya, and then multiplied by dt, integrating both sides. So we will get ln of q is equal to kt plus constant c. So yung nag-integrate tayo dito, may plus na constant dito on this side, nilagay na lang natin on this side, kaya itong plus big letter c na lang. And then we may write this, so we may write c as ln of small letter c. So if big C is equal to ln of small letter c, we may write it as this way, ln of q. Sorry, mukhang m to. So ln of q equal to kt plus ln of c, na small letter c ito. So after writing it this way, pwede natin siyang ilagay sa exponential form para maging q lang ang nandito, wala na yung ln. So equation will be in terms of t sa kabila naman. So q will be equal to e raised to kt and multiplied by e raised to ln of c, and magka-cancel itong ln, and then c will be written right here. So dito. And then we may write this as q is equal to c e raised to kt. So ito yung general equation natin. So sulat lang natin, q is equal to c e raised to kt. So sabi dito, when t is equal to 0 at t is equal to 0, q is equal to 25. Substitute natin to para makakuha tayo ng value para sa mga constant natin, which is c and k. So q therefore is equal to 25 when t is equal to 0. So k, so t is equal to 0, or k times 0 will be equal to 0, and any number, so e raised to 0 will be equal to 1. Therefore, c is equal to 25. Substitute natin itong c is equal to 25 in this equation. So we will get c is equal to 25 e raised to kt. Next, we substitute when t is equal to 2. When t is equal to 2, q is equal to 75. So 75 is equal to 25 e raised to k multiplied by t, which is 2. So solving for k, calculator nyo na lang, k will be equal to, input nyo sa calculator ito, and then solve for x. So lagay nyo, imbes na k dito, is x. So solving for x, ang makukuha niyong x will be 0.55. So k will be 0.55. So ang magiging equation nito is i-substitute lang natin yung k dito sa equation na to. We will get q is equal to 25 e raised to 0.55 multiplied by time. So tinatanong sa equation, find q when t is equal to 6. So when t is equal to 6, q will be equal to 25 e raised to 0.55 t is 6. So q will be equal to, so calculator nyo na lang, q will be equal to 675. When t is equal to 6. So q is equal to 675 when t is equal to 6. So ito ang ating final answer. Wala siyang units kasi wala namang units na nakalagay dito sa q and sa t. So next example, we have here a ball is rolled over a level lawn with initial velocity 25 feet per second. So due to friction, the velocity decreases at the rate of 6 feet per second square. So how far will the ball roll? So if we recall, A is equal to dv over dt, and our acceleration right here is since it is decreasing or decelerating, so our acceleration will be negative, so 6. So we have here negative 6 feet per second square. So gagawin natin is tra-transpose natin yung dt. So dv will be equal to negative 6 dt, and we will integrate both sides. So integrating both sides, we will get, so v is equal to negative 6 t plus mag-i-integrate ulit tayo mamaya. So let's say ang constant lang niya is a. So a ball is rolled over a level lawn with initial velocity of 25 feet per second. So yung velocity daw niya, so v was 25 feet per second at t is equal to 0 second. So nung nag-start siya, that time was 0 second, the velocity was 25 feet per second. So substitute natin sa ating equation, we will get v, or sorry, substitute natin siya. So v 25 is equal to negative 6. So time was 0 plus constant a. So makukuha natin yung constant a will be equal to 25. So our equation will be v is equal to negative 60 plus, substitute natin yung a, so plus 25. So next, recall lang natin. So ang velocity is derivative ng displacement s over with respect to time. So ds over dt. So equate lang natin siya. So ds over dt is equal to negative 6t plus 25. So next transpose natin yung dt. So negative 6t plus 25. So multiplied by dt. If we integrate both sides, we will get dito sa side na to will be s. So yung constant dito, idederecho na lang natin i-transpose sa kabila. So doon na lang sa kabila mamaya i-add yung plus na constant. So sa kabila, we will get pwede natin integrate separately. So integral of negative 6t dt plus integral of 25 dt. So itong una will be s is equal to negative 6t squared over 2 plus yung susunod will be 25t plus yung constant nila from integrating ds, integrating negative 60 dt, and integrating 25 dt. So, yung constant, let's say, b na lang, kasi a yung ginamit natin kanina. So, ayan. So, this one will be, our equation will be negative 6 divided by 2. So, negative 3 t squared plus 25 t plus b. So, wala naman stated sa equation or sa question na displacement niya nung nag-start siya. So, that means s is equal to 0 when t is equal to 0. So, substitute natin to this equation. So, 0 is equal to negative 3, 0 squared plus 25, t, 0 plus b. So, b will be equal to 0. So, meaning, itong constant na to is 0. So, substitute natin sa equation. Our equation will be s is equal to negative 3, t squared plus 25. So, 0 yung B. So, tinatanong sa atin, how far will the ball roll? So, meaning, hanggang saan siya mag-i-stop mag-roll. So, mag-stop siya when B is equal to 0. So, wala na siyang velocity. So, mag-stop siya at di natin alam kung anong time siya. Ano ba yung tinatanong? How far? So, yung distance niya, yung s. So, una, hanapin natin yung time kung gaano katagal siya magro-roll. So, when v is equal to 0 from the equation, v is equal to negative 60. So, v is equal to 0 equal to negative 60 plus 25. So, solving for t, we will get 60 is equal to 25. So, t will be equal to 25 over 6. Next, alam na natin kung gaano katagal siya magro-roll. Substitute na natin siya sa displacement equation natin, which is s. So, s is equal to, di natin alam kung hanggang saan siya or gano'ng kalayo siya magro-roll. So, when t is equal to 25 over 6. So, mag-i-stop siya mag-roll when t is equal to 25 over 6. So, substitute natin siya dito sa s. So, we will get s is equal to negative 3. So, time natin is 25 over 6 squared. Nasaan na tayo? Ito. Plus 25t, which is 25 over 6. So, it will roll. S will be equal to. So, it will roll. 625 over 12 feet. So, calculator nyo na lang siya. So, ito yung ating final answer. So, that is all. Thank you for listening.